Dear students, welcome you all. If you want to make an object to move from one place to the another place, what is the essential one? Yes, force is needed. If you apply enough force, the object remains in its own place. What do you mean by that? That is, you have to increase your force. In other words, your force is insufficient, okay? What do you observe in this picture? A man is playing. He has to apply force to the ball to make it to move. Is it not? So, if you want to make an object to move from one place to the another place, then you have to apply certain force. Then only it will move. So, the force is needed. And the motion. What is motion? The object changes its position with respect to time. So, we can say that the object is in motion. And in this class, we are going to study about what is distance, displacement. You have to differentiate the distance and displacement, and speed, velocity, acceleration, difference between speed and velocity. And we are going to draw and explain about distance time graph and velocity time graphs, and also measure and calculate the speed of the moving objects. We are going to calculate the speed of the moving objects, and finally about center of gravity and stability. We are going to study about all these important concepts of physics in this class. Let us enter into the lesson. Look at this picture here. Kavita can reach her school in two different ways. Will you help her to choose the closest path? Can you tell by choosing which path she could reach the school early? Come, let us help her. This is her school and this is her house. Look at the road A. She has to travel in this road A. By choosing the road A, she can complete the distance of 1.5 km. But if she choose the road B, she has to travel 2 km of distance. Which path is easier for her? Yes, of course, it is 1.5 km. The road A is the shortest distance to reach the school. And look at this picture here. From the tree, leaves are falling. You observe the path A. What is going on here? If you observe the path B, during the windy season, the leaves would travel this path to reach the ground. But if you look at the path A, then the leaves directly reach the ground. And this is the shortest distance to reach the ground. But if you look at the path B, then the leaf is traveling according to the wind. And after that, it makes a curved path and then reach the ground. Uma and Priya are friends studying in the same school. After school hours, they go to the nearby playground, play games and return back home. One day, Uma told that she would reach the playground after visiting the grandma's house. The paths which they took to reach the playground is shown here. Take a twine and measure the length of the two paths. What is the longest path among the two? Come with me, let us measure the path A from school to playground. It is 1 km. And if you measure the distance between the school and grandma's house and to the playground, then it will be 2 km. Which is the longest distance? Yes, of course, the path B is the longest distance and path A is the shortest distance. Now, I think it is very clear for you which one is the shortest distance between the two points. Now let us define what is distance. The total length of a path taken by an object to reach from one place from another place is called a distance. Coming to the next case, displacement. The shortest distance. Here, shortest distance is the keyword. The shortest distance from the initial position to the final position of an object is called a displacement. This picture depicts the difference between the displacement and distance. You consider the point A and the point B. Then this is the shortest distance between these two points. If we have some other work to do at this point, then you have to come here. Then you have to take this path to reach the point B. And this path holds 10 km. Then the total distance by you traveled from A to B is 7 km. But if you consider this path 3, then it is only 5 km. This is the shortest distance between the two points. And this point is called as the displacement. The other path, that is path 1 and path 2, is not the displacement, but it is distance. The path of an object moving from the point A To the point B is shown in the figure, the total distance traveled by the object is 120 meter and the displacement of the object is 40 meter. When you consider the displacement, then you have to note down the direction also. It holds good only when you denote the direction. Okay, when you consider the distance, it is not necessary to denote the direction. But in the displacement, it is necessary to denote the direction. Because distance is the scalar quantity and displacement is the vector quantity. The path in which a rabbit ran is shown in the figure. Let us consider that each square is in an unit of 1 square meter. When you count each box, then you have to cross 1 square meter. Okay. The rabbit starts from the point A and reaches the point B. Come with me. Let us travel with rabbit. The point A and B shows the shortest distance between these two points. And for the second case, it is A and B, which covers only 1 square unit. But if you consider the previous case, it covers 1, 2, 3 square units. Now, see the path of the rabbit. It starts from the point A. Let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. How many squares are there? There are 17 squares. So that rabbit travels from the point A to the point B is 17. That is denoted as distance. Coming to the second part, the rabbit starts from the point A and now let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26 and 27. The total distance traveled by the rabbit in this case is 27. But notice the displacement. It is only 1 square units, is it not? So now I hope that you are very much clear about this concept, that is distance and displacement. When we represent the displacement, we use a positive or negative sign depending on the direction in which it travels. Let us consider the point A as starting point. While the object moves from the point A to the point B, displacement is considered to be positive and it is negative when it travels from the point B to A. Subha goes to the nearby playground from her home. Look at the picture and answer the following questions. What is the distance traveled by her? What is the distance traveled by her? Yes, of course, it is 400 meter. What is the displacement? Yes, of course, it is 100 meter. That's you are right. The distance traveled by an object is 15 kilometer and its displacement is 15 kilometer. What do you infer from this question? Distance and displacement both are same and hence there won't be any extra path traveled by the object and the shortest distance is 15 kilometer. There won't be any other deviation in the path. The distance traveled by a person is 30 kilometer and his displacement is 0 kilometer. What do you infer from this? The person may go some other place and reaches the same point. That is, there won't be any displacement here because he reached the same point. There won't be any two separate points as it in the previous case. From the previous case, we know that there are two points. Suppose you are going to school and you are starting from your house in the morning and you are reaching the same point in the evening to your house. What is the displacement? There won't be any displacement. We have to know the other important one, that is, what is nautical mile? Nautical mile is the unit for measuring the distance in the field of aviation and sea transportation. One nautical mile is 1.852 kilometer. The unit for measuring the speed of aeroplanes and ships is knot. It means that they travel 1 nautical mile in 1 hour. I hope you are enjoyed this animation and explanations. I'll meet you in the super good topic in physics in the next class. Thank you for watching.